Okay guys, what is up? This is Wan's other bike, the Hayabusa. And maybe you want to tell her her name?
Okay, her name is Gabriella.
Gabriella, I think you tell me before. Yes, yeah, I remember.
Her name is Gabriella.
Alamak, this one is like, you know, the Lamborghini of all bike, you know. Is every rider knows what is this on the road. So I'm going to give you guys a bit of background on the Suzuki Hayabusa GSX 1300R. The Suzuki Hayabusa, or Busa, is a sports bike made by Suzuki lah. It gained a reputation for being the world's fastest production motorcycle with a top speed of 303 to 312 kilometers per hour when it first came out in 1999 lah. So the Hayabusa is actually Japanese for Peregrine Falcon, and the name is actually meant to poke fun at its rival lah, the Honda CBR 1100XX Super Blackbird, which at that time was the world's fastest production motorcycle lah. The choice of name was made because the Peregrine Falcon preys on blackbirds, and the Suzuki Hayabusa eventually eclipsed the title and it managed to surpass the Super Blackbird by at least 16 kilometers per hour lah. So the bike is manufactured in Toyokawa, Japan and India. It can be found all over the world lah. So everybody knows what is this. However, to comply with European regulations, 2000 and after Hayabusa models are electronically limited to 299 kilometers per hour lah, making the first year model of 1999 sought after by collectors. So besides its speed, the Hayabusa has been lauded by many riders for its all-round performance. It does not drastically compromise other qualities such as handling, reliability, or fuel consumption, or speed. So the engine is a 1299cc liquid-cooled 4-stroke inline-4 DOHC 16-valve with a fuel injection fuel system and 6-speed manual transmission. The same engine is also used in the second generation Suzuki B-King, a Street Fighter motorcycle lah. Okay, so in Singapore, the Hayabusa has gained a reputation for being an exotic class 2 motorbike. Amongst riders, it does turn heads. It has a cult following and everybody knows what a Hayabusa is. There's a lot of biker groups that link up Hayabusa riders and organize meetups, touring trips, charity rides, and riders share their passion of owning such a bike lah. Okay Wan, this is your weekend bike ah.
Yeah.
So-called weekend, the rich people would say, like, how to say, you know, the rich people, they will drive a Ford in the weekday, and then the weekend, they drive a very supercar or something like that. Lah. So this is one's weekend bike, so-called Gabriella. So why a Hayabusa?
This is actually my second Hayabusa.
Oh wait, Wan has a nickname. His name is Wan Busa, by the way.
Yeah, that's what the guys at work call me, though.
The
reason why Hayabusa is actually because back then, when I was riding or starting to learn how to ride a bike during my class 2B days, so I actually got passed by this. There was this bike that actually sped past me. So I actually thought that if I'm not wrong, I checked with my friend. My friend told me that was a Blackbird. So initially I fell in love with a Blackbird, the Honda Blackbird,
the rival lah of
the Hayabusa. The rival of the Hayabusa. So I actually fell in love with the Blackbird until I think a few years where I decided that point of time was that when I get my class 2, I'm gonna get Hayabusa. A Blackbird.
A Blackbird.
So when I actually during my class 2A days, I actually worked with some friends who actually have a Hayabusa. So I was saying that I like this bike, but then I didn't know the name. So I actually said, "Is this a Blackbird?" You know, I asked them. So they were very offended, you know.
Of course lah. Hayabusa riders are very particular.
So they actually were like, "Hey, no, don't say that Blackbird lah. We are not Blackbird. Okay, we are Hayabusa." So I actually sort of like got interested with the name. So I looked up on the internet about the bike. I looked up about its model and then everything. So it started to be something that I love lah. So back then I decided that my class 2 bike, the first bike that I want to have, will be a Hayabusa. So I bought, I think when I passed my class 2A today, and then in the afternoon I went to the shop. I just took out the Hayabusa that I actually wanted. I think few
class 2
ago.
Right?
Yeah,
class 2A.
I passed my class 2.
You pass only, you straight away get this.
Not this.
Or another one, the older one.
First by Hayabusa. So I passed in the morning, and then after that in the afternoon I think I went over to my bike shop and I just exchanged the bike with the Hayabusa and I took it out on the same day. as when I passed.
Oh, you're really passionate about this bike.
Yeah, actually, by then I was really in love with the bike. Everything was Hayabusa, Hayabusa, Hayabusa in the mind. Yeah.
Okay, so this is what people don't understand. Like people say, hey, why you want to get a big bike? For what? You cannot go fast anyway. But this is the passion, you know. Some riders, they really love the particular model. That's why they choose to get it. Even though you cannot really go very fast with the bike. Is it?
In Singapore.
But you play track, right?
No. I tried twice. No offense to any track goers out there, but I don't really find it something for me. It's not for me lah, in a way. You know, a track is not for me. I'm not saying track is not good. I went there before, I tried track before, but it's not for me. I think I would prefer touring rather than going to track lah. Mm. But I do enjoy some people who went for their track days and see the videos and everything, but I don't really enjoy doing it lah. Mm. I've done it twice, I think, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, but that was it lah, in a way.
How's the monthly expenditure for this bike? Like how to say, the fuel consumption, your maintenance, you know?
Yeah. Okay, as you may know, I think I have my FZ16 with me.
Mm,
so, even though you can call it a weekend bike, I don't bring it out every weekend. Because, you know, sometimes I don't have the time. Sometimes I don't just feel like riding it, you know? So once a while I will take it out. So actually with that, if you're talking about monthly expenditure, usually my average is about 3 to 4 months that I would just go for servicing. That is if I actually ride quite a bit lah for the few months. If not, I can take up to about 6 months.
Wow.
Because I rarely ride the bike, you see. So like, I save a lot lah.
Don't mind me asking, what's the frequency of you riding?
You can say in a month, on average, about 2 to 3 times.
2 to 3 times.
Yeah, it depends lah. Because the thing is, sometimes, if you are invited for a wedding escort, that's one thing that obviously I will go. And then after that, if you know that some of your friends are riding or going anywhere, you know, so like
touring lah, like Johor, for example.
Yeah, either Johor or just riding in Singapore. Or just a short trip to Malacca, come back on the same day, you know, this kind of stuff. So that probably will be when I will ride lah. But on average, that happens maybe in a month about 3-4 times, 2-3-4 times around there. It doesn't happen a lot lah, in a way. So that's one thing good for me, because I really save a lot lah on the bike. Just that Monday, I just have to pay the installment lah.
Which is how much, I don't mind me?
It's just below 500.
Below 500 lah.
Just below 500.
So, total price the bike with the machine and COE.
The bike, I bought it second hand. Okay, so at that point of time when I bought the bike, COE was just below 8 years. And then I bought the bike. I tied the installment for 5 years. So, yeah.
Nanti aku calculate. Later I calculate lah. I think you cannot every month. I think every month just pay only lah.
Yeah,
you never really think about it lah. So having Hayabusa, right? What are the reactions you get on the road?
I think nowadays I think people don't really. I think from on average, if you see on the road, very difficult for you to see maybe Hayabusas or those sport tourers lah. Like the Hayabusas, the Z14s and the Concourse. I think the younger generation of riders, you could say, I actually would prefer the S1000s and the R1s and the Rabbits and the Fireblade and all the stuff lah. So I mean, it's their preference, I think, which is not a problem for me. But sometimes you do get. When you're riding, people would give way to you, people will wave to you, you know. But you as a rider, I also would do the same lah. Sometimes I would initiate, you know. There will be people that would just like say hi lah. Either a hi or not, you know, on the road. That's the good thing lah. But to me, it doesn't matter about the bike. Even if I ride my FZ16, you know, I just see a guy riding maybe a S1000 or an R1 or Z10R or what, just like,
because you love the bike,
yeah.
Yeah, you know. That's the purpose of you buying the bike in the first place. Right? It's about you, not about other people.
Yeah, correct.
I know you rarely ride it, but has the bike so far given you any issues, any problems?
I think for this Hayabusa, I think it has been the most perfect one for me. It has never given any major issues except for I think last year there was a problem with the coil, the magnetic coil. Mm. Yeah, so I got that change, but other than that, that's it lah. That's the only major so-called repair that I had to do with this one. I mean, the previous one don't talk lah. There were a lot of things.
Okay, the previous one, what problems?
Previous one, I had to actually. It's not that I had to. But I just decided to do a top overhaul for that particular bike. That one was very, very costly. It was, I think, above 4K.
Wow.
Yeah, just above 4K. And then after that, there was certain things that need to be done lah. I only rode my first Hayabusa for about 3 years. 3 years plus, I think. Then I decided to try the Z14, which I rode for about a year. And then no offense to the Z14 riders, if there are, but I still prefer the Hayabusa. Without a doubt, I will prefer the Hayabusa any day of the week.
Is it, what are the difference between the Z14 and the Hayabusa? Is it handling?
Okay, firstly, I think for me personally, I would feel that the Z14 is lighter. And then you cannot take the fact that the Z14 is faster. That is, without a doubt, it's faster. But then I still think that when it comes to riding at constant speed, I think the Hayabusa is a bit more stable, you know. And then the aerodynamic is in the wind, the wind pressure that is on you, you know, is not that bad when it comes to the Hayabusa compared to the Z14. For me lah, that's what I think. That's why, I mean, for me, I had the luxury of riding both, so I still, for me, prefer the Hayabusa.
So this bike has always been your dream lah.
This is my favorite.
Your favorite lah.
Yeah.
So how does it feel when you first got it? You know, when you got your your class 2 license lah, you straight away buy it to the shop. How do you, how does it feel?
That was because I was riding a Super 4
at that time.
Trading my Super 4, took out the Haya on the very same day. The minute I tried to turn the throttle, it was a whole different feeling. It was a whole different feeling, and then after that, when I was riding, you know, you just felt like, wow, you're going so fast. When you look at the meter, you'll be like, hey, 160, 170, you know, you have to slow down. Because the type of bike that this is, it doesn't really make you feel that you're going fast, but actually you are going fast. Because maybe the weight is heavy.
Because it's very stable.
Yeah, but it's very stable to me. So the very first time I rode the bike, that was at the peak of the love that I have for the bike. Really, I tell you, it's a wonderful feeling lah that I actually managed to get the Hayabusa, and then after that I rode it, and when riding it was amazing.
So final question, what's the best memories you have with Gabriella?
Every time I hit the border at Thailand with Hayabusa, it's amazing feeling. Every time. It doesn't have to be, I mean, going up with my FZ, it was that was that one moment where it's actually, it made me riding the FZ become one of the best moments. But when it comes to my Hayabusa, I think every moment, the minute I reach the border, I see Thailand just, you know, a few meters away, I think that's, to me, the most memorable moment. Every time, it never gets old, it never gets boring, it never gets tiring to me, every time. And this baby has been with me every time. Every time without
But it's not built for touring, huh? Is it built for touring?
It's not. In terms of, I think because if I'm not wrong, they call it a sport tourer.
Sport tourer.
So, when it comes to touring, if you're referring to maybe putting your luggage, so-called luggage, and all the stuff, I think you know when I travel very light. So, yeah, I will usually just put stuff on the back, and then I have this spider netting. I just wrap it over, and then I'll just do another few more knots to secure lah. I think so far, I think I've gone through quite fast speeds. Yeah, never fallen off.
But anything else you want to say?
No. It's okay. Stay safe, ride safe, and then wear your mask. Don't forget.
Okay, well, I want to thank you so much for giving me the chance to review your bikes and telling me your story on why you got them. Yeah. It's such an honor. I mean, I met one. Like, he's a very nice guy. Very nice guy.
Thanks.
Okay, man.
Okay. Thanks.
Take care.
Thank you, man.
Ride safe out there. And we'll see you in the next one.